So now let me give you the practical. Okay, now the reason I'm telling you this is because you know how attorneys a lot of times that are uneducated, they want to rush the case through and get it processed out. That's called an uneducated attorney. That's when you have not did educational sales with that attorney. Okay? So does that mean you can't give an impairment rating or don't want to give an impairment rating until after 12 months from the injury? No. Here's what my suggestion is to be able to defend yourself and sound smart about it. At least let the injury be in the remodel phase. At least. Do you see how it would be stupid to give an impairment rating in the repair phase? The person's still healing. There's still collagen synthesis. That would be stupid. Now, guess who needs to educate their attorney on the three phases of healing? You do. And by the way, guess what that's going to do to help stop him from ripping the patient out from under you and settling the case? It's going to stop that crap. Okay? So the guideline, the guideline we like to use is as long as you have two re-exam periods, because I do want to check, right? I want two thresholds, right? I want two time periods to see if they're going. I can't see if the person's going up by looking at one time period, can I? Not, right? If there's a change here and change here, like if you did a re-exam here and a re-exam here and there's change here and change here, that doesn't fit the definition, does it? Because they're changing. So I want to see two time periods. When I say time periods, what am I talking about? Re-exams. when I do what? I check the biomarkers. I quantify the biomarkers, right? So when I have two time periods where when I quantify the biomarkers, I don't see any change. Does that make sense? But where? At least in the remodel phase. Okay? Can you see how that would make a lot more sense? There's no more collagen synthesis. Now you're just working on elasticity and strength, right? So if I'm just working on elasticity and strength, and I'm in the remodel phase, and I have two time periods, two re-exams, where I don't see any change, that is the earliest at which I would call an injury MMI. And feel totally good and comfortable about telling you, the juror, how I came to that conclusion. If you were the jury and I just explained that to you, how much sense would that make? See how that works?